Alright, welcome back to the channel, and in today's video we are talking about the Balenciaga Fall Winter 2020 show by Demna Vassallia. So for some background, Demna Vassallia is the current creative director of Balenciaga, and he's a Georgian fashion designer. He's well known for his work at Vetements, and that is kind of what made him rise to prominence in the fashion industry. He also studied for a master's degree in fashion design at the famous Royal Academy of Arts in Antwerp. And before he started Vetements, he was well known in the industry, and he had worked for the likes of Maison Margiela, Louis Vuitton, and he had also been tutored by Walter Van Barendonk. Now, I can characterize Demna Vassallia's work with a lot of irony, and I feel like in the industry he gets a lot of unfair criticism. Now, Demna Vassallia is obviously a really intelligent designer, and Demna Vassallia's bread and butter is knowing his customers and knowing how to market. So what Demna Vassallia does is he creates a buzz by making really outlandish designs, like, you know, the seven layer parka, the t-shirt, shirt. And what that is made to do is to make sure that everyone continues talking about Balenciaga, and Balenciaga is kind of at the forefront of fashion. And I think Demna understands the climate of fashion right now, and he understands kind of like meme culture and things like that. But I feel like a lot of the time, in the mainstream, this detracts from how good of a designer Demna Vassallia is. And if we talk about Demna Vassallia's design, if we talk about things like normcore, a lot of that does come from Demna Vassallia in terms of Demna Vassallia making statements. I like a lot of his references. A lot of the time, Demna Vassallia, he references his childhood growing up in Georgia. So that's why you see a lot of football references. You see a lot of church references and things like that. There was even a collection he designed at Vetements where he actually, it was inspired by kind of the war in Georgia and kind of what happened and the countries that were involved in that. So Demna has a lot to say. Demna has also made collections that are kind of a commentary on capitalism. That's why he'll take well-known brands and then change the branding on a lot of these collections. A lot of the way he designs as well, he makes fun of how ridiculous fashion is, and that's why there's so much irony in the way he can just print on a t-shirt and sell it for 600. To some people it's like, oh, it's crazy, but when you understand Demna Vassallia and you understand the thought process that goes into it, it starts to make a lot of sense. Now, moving on to the collection we're talking about, which is the Fall Winter 2020 collection. This is definitely one of my favorite Demna Vassallia Balenciaga collections. Yeah, it was just amazing. And there are many, like, a lot of looks in this collection. So what I'll do is I'll leave kind of like something on the screen where you can see all the looks as I'm talking, because to get into them one by one, this video would be like 5 hours long. So going into the first big talking point of the collection, this was the set. So on the set, we saw kind of like the floor being flooded. And there was a lot of water on the ground level of the set. On the ceiling also, we saw different changes of environments and things that looked like fiery skies, polluted skies, the earth. And we saw a lot of images. And what this was made to signify was climate change. And a lot of this collection was kind of a commentary on the effects of fashion on the climate and just the sphere of the world today with all the climate change issues. And I have a quote from Demna Vassallia, and when he was asked about this collection and why he decided to talk about climate change in this collection, he said, "I like to see fashion as a reflection of what is going on in the society around us." And that is kind of what Demna Vassallia does all the time. That's his bread and butter. But I think what I personally loved about this collection so much was the water level was so high that the first three rows, or first few rows of the Balenciaga show actually were unoccupiable. And this just goes back into the genius of Demna Vassallia, that basically what he's saying by doing that is saying that no one, when he wants to make a protest and make a statement about climate change, no one is too high or is above his protests. Even the people that would normally sit in the front rows. So no one is immune to a Demna Vassallia protest, so to speak. So yeah, I love that this collection and the set was kind of a slap in the face to fashion's big shots. And he didn't care that he ostracized the esteemed guests of the show in favor of his protest. That is the most Demna Vesalia thing ever. So now moving into the garment in this collection, the first few looks anyway, were all black, and there were a sea of a lot of black looks. Personally, black is a color associated with darkness and funerals and death, and obviously this is the perfect color when you're making a protest on climate change, to have a lot of looks in black and kind of show that we're kind of transitioning into a dark era in the world and in fashion in general. In this collection, in terms of like the garment silhouette, a lot of the garments had a lot of volume, and in terms of the shoulders, we saw a lot of pieces that had kind of broad shoulders and exaggerated shoulders. And we saw these pieces in the collection that were kind of reminiscent of what you would see a Catholic priest wear, especially when you look at looks such as looks 2, 10, and 45. Quoting Demna Vesalia in terms of his inspiration for this part of the collection, he actually said, "I went to church to confess every Saturday. Back then, I remember looking at all these young priests and monks wearing these long robes and thinking, how beautiful. You see them around Europe with their beards, hair knotted back, and backpacks. I don't know, I find it quite hot, but that's my fetish." So I find it really cool that basically what Demna Vesalia is saying, and I think he had a quote later on that I'm going to read. He's talking about how he likes the idea of men don't wear dresses, but when a priest wears something that is kind of reminiscent of a dress, it's like a long gown, it's seen as masculine, and he fetishizes that look, and he likes that you can wear something that is kind of like in the gray area between masculine and feminine. And if you look at the looks in this collection, there are a lot of those like priest robes that look kind of masculine on the men, and there's some more feminine ones on the woman, that kind of, they're very unisex and they just drape down. There's no real like curvature or any silhouette that would suggest it's made for women. And this was also kind of a reference to original Balenciaga under Cristobal Balenciaga. And if you guys don't know who Cristobal Balenciaga is, he's the person who created Balenciaga, the Spanish designer. And Cristobal Balenciaga used to make these really long dresses, drapey dresses for noble women to wear to church in Spain. So Demna Vesalia, once again, and this is where the genius of Demna Vesalia is kind of lost, because some people, when they look at Balenciaga shows, they can't look past 5 looks out of 105 that have Balenciaga print t-shirts. And if you look deeper into the references, you can see that a lot of the garments he references original Cristobal Balenciaga. And I think a lot of the reason why he even referenced Cristobal more in this collection than he would in the past is because he's showing his first couture collection for Balenciaga. So this is kind of Demna Vesalia showing that I'm ready for this couture, and literally I can reference Cristobal, I can take my references from anywhere really. Another underrated part of Demna Vesalia's design is his tailoring. And we saw amazing tailoring in this collection. And I think, once again, going back to the couture, he just wanted to kind of showcase his skill in terms of tailoring and how well he can do his sort of boxy tailoring silhouette. At the same time, obviously, it wouldn't be a Demna Vesalia collection without something being exaggerated. Like I said in the past, there are kind of these exaggerated shoulders, with some of them looking like spikes and almost going up to people's ears. And this can signify many things. Obviously, back in the day, back in the 90s, the 80s, there was this whole concept of power tailoring. And that was when suits went from like this kind of normal silhouette to having really exaggerated shoulders. And that was supposed to signify at the time kind of power and strength and kind of, you know, being outlandish, being stable, being bold. And now what is signifying is all those things, as well as protection, because what does being bold and being strong and strength signify? It's kind of like you're strong, you can protect yourself against things. And thinking about this collection being a protest against climate change, it makes a lot of sense how the boxy silhouettes and kind of the really big shoulders could be used as a signifier for protection against climate change. Now, one of my favorite parts of this collection is a lot of the looks, we saw models having kind of like these black eyes or red eyes, and it kind of, they were wearing kind of like sort of these contact lenses that made them look like almost demons. And I'm going to read a quote from Demna Vassallia, and then I'm going to talk about why I love it so much. So when asked about what this was meant to signify, Demna Vassallia said, "Religious codes are all about hiding the body, about being ashamed. Body and sex is the taboo. Whereas when you look into it, some of these people are the nastiest perverts." So this, oh my God, this guy's a genius, man. So what he's done here is you have these looks where he's talking about he fetishizes kind of like the Catholic robes and the silhouettes you can get from these type of robes. And it reminds him of his childhood because there was a lot of Catholic influence in Georgia when he was growing up. He's also saying, however, that being said, people who are, you know, a lot of Catholics in general and a lot of people that dress in a very, in a way where they cover up their body, some of them can actually be the biggest pervert. So that sort of showing I'm so holy, I'm so this, I'm so that is kind of a front. And that's why you have a lot of cases where priests can be perverts or things like that. And yeah, the way he juxtaposed kind of using the same silhouettes that is associated with Catholics and priests and then mixing that with kind of just a contact lens that can signify the juxtaposition between good and bad, that's genius. Like, I have to clap. I know no one's here, it's just me, but I have to clap. That's crazy. And transitioning from this idea, which once again, Demna Vassallia, man, he's a genius. And this goes back to, just because I didn't like a few Vetements collections, people think I hate Demna Vassallia. No. People, once again, are just a bit immature when it comes to things like that. But going back to the genius of Demna Vassallia, so he's taken the idea of the fact that a lot of Catholics, they feel there's this idea of restriction in the way they can dress because they have to cover up their body. And he's transitioned this idea of restriction into other garments. And that's why we see a lot of these kind of biker jackets. Because when you ride a bike, like a motorbike, there's a restriction on what you can wear, because if you fall off, you have to be wearing the right equipment to make sure that you don't have skin burns or you don't get skin damage. And that can also be juxtaposed with the idea of the fact that biker clothing is also skin tight to your body. And that's why a lot of the other pieces also look like kind of like skin tight suits that are reminiscent of what you would see a surfer wear. And also those looks can also be looked at as, because they're walking in water and climate change, that's the perfect equipment to help you survive in the midst of a lot of water. Near the end of the collection, we also saw a lot of football jerseys and football players, and we saw these looks that had like literally, they looked like football players. They had a football top, the football shorts, the long socks that are reminiscent of what you'll see a footballer play, and then the AstroTurfs. Now, I really like how he used it in this collection, because in the last collection, he had the Tyrexes on the runway, but the Zen sneakers weren't on the runway. They were just a random shoe out of nowhere that he released. So it was just kind of out of place. And I even made a video as to like why the materials are, I don't like them, but in this collection, it makes a lot of sense, because now he's brought it into a collection where there are a lot of references to his Georgian childhood. And that makes so much sense, because in Georgia, in most European countries anyway, football is a big influence. And I think going to the Demna Vassallia quotes, so Demna Vassallia said himself, "Footballers and priests were what I grew up with in Georgia." So he's literally said it himself. What he grew up with was footballers and priests. So yeah, I like the cohesion in which he's used the AstroTurfs and like the Zen sneakers. I'm not sure if the shoes in this collection were the Zens or if they're like a lookalike to the Zens, but either way, it's more cohesive in this collection as opposed to some random Zen sneaker out of nowhere. Would I pay £600 for a polyurethane sneaker? I don't think so, but I love how it was used in this collection for sure. Another part of this collection that a lot of people were talking about was the collaboration with Vibram, and he kind of made his design on the five finger silhouette, which is quite cool, because the five finger silhouette, they look like paddling shoes, And this goes back to the idea of that's the perfect attire to wear in water in climate change. So once again, a lot of this collection going into the tailoring with the boxy shoulders that are meant to represent protection, to going into wearing the right attire with wearing these kind of shoes reminiscent of diving shoes and shoes that you're supposed to wear in the water, even down to the materials being made of rubber, which is waterproof. A lot of this collection was about how to protect yourself against climate change, which was really cool. Of course, there was more to this collection that I could get into. One of my favorite looks was this really massive, voluminous pleated dress. That was one of my favorite collections, but also Denim Versalia wouldn't be such a commercial success if in all his collections, there wasn't something for every single person in his collection. So he can reference, have all these references and still make sure that the collection is balanced, and I think it takes a genius to do that. And this is what comes from people that are on this level of fashion design, and these are the type of things you learn when you work at places like Margiela, and you learn under Walter van Beurendonck, and you gain those type of skills. So in this collection, we saw a lot of denim pieces, we saw workwear, we saw tailoring, we've seen a little bit of sportswear, the spandex stuff and the football jerseys. We've seen dresses, we've seen the priest gowns. There's literally something in there for everyone. So yeah, amazing, amazing collection. Comment down below what your thoughts are on this collection. I'm definitely looking forward to seeing Couture from Demna Vesalia. That's crazy. I'll be back with another video soon. Comment down below what collections you want to see me review. And yeah, thank you for watching.